Monks of Loop has just arrived. In today's video, we're going to give you everything that you need to know about Loop and what it does, how it works, a little bit of a preview of it, and also summarizing my personal thoughts about where it's heading for Microsoft. So I'm very, very excited, and I'm gonna take you along for the ride with Microsoft Loop, so let's dive in. So welcome there, my name is Francesco D'Alessio. I am very excited, I'm a big fan of productivity tools, so if you are new to Keep Productive, do subscribe, it'd be great to have you. And if you want to find the perfect productivity tool that is right for you, you can find Toolfinder in the link in the description below. So let's start with what Microsoft Loop is. Now, fundamentally, Microsoft Loop has been around for a little bit of time. It's been around in the name of Fluid Framework, which was basically this model or experience that Microsoft built so that components could be accessed through multiple Microsoft 365 apps. So say you're editing something here in Microsoft Teams and it can show live what it was doing in OneNote. And that was a really cool concept. And they've weaved it all together, mashed it up into Microsoft Loop. Now, it is similar to Notion, but I'll get into that later on. To start, I want to summarize three core features of it and then move on to a demo. So the three core features include workspaces, pages, and components. Components being the most interesting element of this. So let's start with workspaces. Now, very simply, workspaces are essentially projects. They're different areas or spaces that you can go into and naturally build a different workspace for you, whether that's bringing in different tool, like things that already exist in Microsoft, like a OneDrive link or a Excel link, whatever it is, you can bring it all into that workspace and you can actually build stuff inside of there. So they're sort of separating things out. The second is pages, and that's basically each page can be a different thing. It can be a canvas for you to start writing and creating components, but it can also be an Excel sheet or a Word document, whatever it be, it allows you to do that. And third, and most importantly, is Loop components. Remember what I was saying at the start about Loop components being these things that live between different applications? Well, they are real. they're living now. Well, Loop components have been around a little bit inside of Microsoft Teams and Outlook for some time now, but now they're this formulated experience and you can create components. So for example, if I create a component inside of a page, that component can live in multiple locations, be edited in real time with other people. So what's different about that to say something like Google Docs is, if you're in Google Docs, you're in Google Docs, and say I sent that via Google Chat, you still have to go out to the link to Google Docs. It's not breathing and living. So for example, if you were in Microsoft Teams and you pasted a Loop component or you created a Loop component from there, you could share that Loop component with other people and they'd see what is happening in real time as long as they're in a Microsoft 365 app that allows Loop components to be posted and naturally utilized. It is a really, really exciting element of this and really does take it that step further. So I want to pause, show you the demo video that they have launched with today's update, and then we're going to come back and we're actually going to look at Microsoft Loop, and I'm going to give you some things about it that I really like and a little bit more about how it works.
Say goodbye to the frustration of jumping between apps and losing track of documents and ideas. Microsoft Loop transforms the way you work, so you can think, plan, and create together like never before. Loop is made up of workspaces, pages, and components. Let's break it down. Create together with shared workspaces for each of your projects. On the Loop homepage, you can access all your existing workspaces and create new ones. In a Loop workspace, you can bring everything you need for your project together in one place. To kick off a workspace, Loop can even do the searching for you, making it easy to add existing project-related information and organize it into pages. Continue adding to your workspace as your project evolves and organize it the way you want. Loop pages are flexible canvases where you can react, comment, and build on each other's ideas. Notifications help you track the things you care about and focus on what matters, all while staying in the flow of your work. Copilot in Loop helps you ideate and co-create. Get inspired with AI-powered contextual suggestions to transform the way you create together. Don't let app barriers slow your project down. Easily share information with people outside your workspace with Loom components. Components are portable pieces of content that stay in sync across all the places they have been shared, no matter where they are updated. You can share components and create new ones, like lists, tables, paragraphs, and more, across your favorite Microsoft 365 apps. You're always in control because it's easy to see where components were shared and who has access. However you work, wherever you work, Loom enables teams to think, plan, and create together like never before.
So here we are with the public preview, and naturally I've been given access to it early and I've been playing around with it. So this naturally isn't necessarily the final version. So just FYI, if you see or spot any issues. So as I said, it's broken into three parts. What you've got here to initially start is the workspace. So you can create a new workspace based on a project that you have that you might want, and you can utilize some of these icons. As I said, it's probably still being worked on in the background, so it won't necessarily be the final version. But here you can update the cover, and I've titled it Workspace A. You can invite people as well. Now, what I find particularly cool is this function. So there's actually some AI content suggestions initially added to Loom, which I find pretty cool. So if you have anything in your Microsoft 365 areas that is connected, I actually don't have that many because I set up a Microsoft account specifically for this, but I can bring in certain things that live already in different areas. These are all Loom things, so it's a bad example, but you can bring in Word, different files, different things like that, and you can actually use keywords to prompt it to search in other places. So really cool. I'll add the welcome area. Bang, create. So it's now gone and created me a new area. And you can see from here, it's very Notion X. It's very clear, it's very nice, simple looking. I wanna start in the top left-hand corner. So notifications, you can see here that Kevin mentioned me here in another area. This is the place where we've just been literally going mental. So FYI. So notifications, you can have them live across the different areas that you have. So this is now a different area, so I can actually go back and find it here. So that's quite a cool one for jumping across. I'm sure they'll add something that allows you to jump across. Hey, it's Command J, sorry. Command J, you can find and move across your workspaces. So that's really cool. I'm a Loom pro. Not. So up here, there's a really nice one where you can see recent stuff. This is cool because it's across all of the locations and workspaces. And you can see who's active now, which is really nice. I love this area. I think Notion should add something like this, but I guess it's sort of like private Notion. But here, what you can do is create ideas. So you can make spaces that naturally don't get interrupted with other people's thoughts. So that's really cool. Shared ideas, you could have things pretty slim there. And you can move workspaces here. You can browse all of them, start a new one, sort them based on tree of hierarchy or activity, which is really nice. And I'm going to start showing you a page because else I will be here for ages. Page B, you can add an icon, you can add a cover, and you can use some of Microsoft's pre-installed ones. So you may notice down here, this is really nice. You've got some very simple structured templates, only 10, so definitely falling behind many of the other competitors. But if I use this template, bang, I can go ahead and create stuff. And you can create like this, is a table here. So you're thinking, oh, this is a very cool little table. I can interact with it. And if you kept this inside of Loom, then you know, it's pretty simple, like in terms of his abilities, like, but this is where I can invite people as well, which is cool. But if I were to switch on the magic, let me find the magic, it's here. I'm really bad at controlling Loom at the moment. I need to be a Loom pro. And I can create this into a Loom component. And you can see instantaneously, this ring appears around the Loom component. And what's cool here is I can copy the component. So when I copy the component, I can bring it into other applications, I can share out an email, and I can move forward with it, which is really cool. So other things that you can do is you can carry on editing, and this will be in real time modified, which is really cool. And you can move stuff about. I quite like how dynamic and easy it is to be able to move stuff. It feels quite snappy. I don't know, it's marginal, but I wouldn't say this is drastically behind anything that's out there already. It is quite responsive, quite fast. And you've got other abilities like sorting, hiding columns. You have not got proper filtering yet, and naturally some of the other elements you might have. But this is now a Loom component. I can share it in different places, which is very, very cool. And if I go up to the top here, I can see, okay, what do I want to share? Do I want to share the workspace, the page link, or do I want to embed the Loom component in other places? So that's how that works up here. Now, the settings are very basic because I'm in here, but you can go to a dark mode if you did want to. Let's show you the welcome page. So this is a bit of it demonstrated. So yes, I am active on this page, but you can naturally have other people interact with you. And the same goes on mobile too, to be a really interactive workspace. I've got nice breadcrumbs here, very simple, nice and easy here. So I can create a new page or add a new link. So if you ever have any URLs that you're like, okay, this is in Trello, then you can have it weaved in here. So other aspects of it, let me see if anything's knocking about. You can also copy it as a Loom component as a whole. So that's quite cool. So that's speedier way of doing it. Top right-hand corner, I could sign out. There's nothing really more, and that's why I will explain why it's sort of still not fully there compared to the likes of, say, Notion in terms of its abilities. So we were just literally just posting and playing around with the concept. I like this though, here we go. This is a good way to demonstrate. Shared locations, you can actually see where that's shared and who has access to it, which is really cool. So I really like that ability, and you can see who's been interacting with it as well. So that is the public preview of Microsoft Loom. Okay, so now you've had a look at the public preview of Microsoft Loom. What is the opinion? There are a few questions already out here. Where is Microsoft Loom going? What is it going to do with the AI side of stuff? And how does it compare to Notion? I think those are probably the three ones that mainly people have. So where is Microsoft Loom headed? I really like components. I think components is a really interactive experience that saves time going into files and that monotonous work. Something you can update in real time, but it's really, really nice to use. The only thing I think will struggle will be the organization of components. And that's sort of where Loom pages and workspaces are for, but it's also the sort of where is everything in my areas will be interesting to see and evolve for Microsoft Loom. But I definitely think it's quite exciting, and where it's heading is definitely a big step forward for Microsoft. And the way that I see it is a little bit the way that I see Microsoft Teams. And before the pandemic, they were really falling behind with Slack. And then suddenly when the pandemic happened, because the distribution, they had a lot of people using Microsoft 365, I think it almost 4x'd or 5x'd the amount of users post-pandemic. And that's a really interesting thing that Microsoft has, because so many people use them that the distribution access for those using it actually really works in its favor. So I think because it works across lots of different things, people might just start moving to Loom as this sort of like middle ground buddy that they can just use to get work done faster. So I think that's quite exciting, and I'm just waiting for that distribution to really tie things up and really understanding the message especially. I also think that Loom can go much, much, much further with AI. I have seen some stuff with the AI, but I'm probably gonna do a separate video because naturally, in the public preview, I'm not sure they're fully ready to explain that. I demonstrated some of the stuff in the preview video we just did, but I don't want to talk. I want to talk about how that is separately because I have some opinions there. So what were the other things? number two, I think, is about Notion. Notion is such a large market at the moment, and Microsoft obviously saw that with the Canvas abilities. They sort of added the workspace and pages as a way to directly compete with Notion, but I don't think it's necessarily there yet. I think Notion has a lot of elements that really takes it a lot further. I think there are some nice things in Microsoft Loop, like ideas, recent, and some of the AI abilities that are core and grounded to what you have in Microsoft already that are definitely time-saving. But I think the issue that Microsoft face is the fact that you have to be using all of the Microsoft services to take advantage of Loop. So if you want to message, you have to be using Teams. If you want to communicate with OneNote, you have to be using OneNote. And there's these fragmented experiences. Whilst you can communicate with these components across the platforms, there is naturally a struggle there. So I do think that's going to be quite a big element initially. I don't think people are going to be leaving in droves to go from Notion over to Loop. But for example, if a large team already uses 365 and they're looking to cut costs, especially during some particularly difficult times that we may potentially be facing as time goes on and even now, then I think maybe that would be more financially viable to weave everything into what you already have. So that's why I mean, coming back to distribution, it could potentially be beneficial to move back to Microsoft Loop and just have everything live there and breathe there. So it could potentially work in their favor if there was, say, something that pressured people to reduce their expenditure on their subscriptions and things like that. Just a hypothetical thought to this, but of course teams are looking to save money and save stress loads at the same time. So that was Microsoft Loop. I will be doing a separate video on the AI elements of Loop and how that affects it. But if you are interested in some other videos that we've done, a video about Microsoft Copilot 365 if you want to check that out. And of course, you can check out our wide range of videos over on Keep Productive or find the best productivity tool for you on Toolfinder. Anyway, folks, a big thank you very much. And I hope to see you back in another video. Microsoft Loop, a very interesting solution from Microsoft that has a long way to go, but still very, very exciting. Thank you very much, everyone, and I'll see you all very soon. Cheerio.